Today we will start our experiment number one, that is basic laboratory techniques. Okay, you see basic laboratory techniques. First one is here, cutting a glass tube, bending a glass tube, drawing a glass jet, boring a cork, fitting the glass tube in the bowl. Okay, so first cutting of glass tube and glass rod. Cutting of glass tube and glass rod. Okay, then bending of glass tube, drawing of a glass jet, boring a cork, fitting the glass tube in a bowl. Okay, so first we'll do cutting a glass tube. So you see, children, this is a glass tube. How will cut? Okay, first you take the glass tube, then at the middle of the glass tube. Okay, you mark with your marker pen. Okay. With marker pen, you mark one line. Okay, children. With marker pen, you circle one line. You see, this is your mark. Okay. At that mark, this is your triangular file. Triangle shape or not? Triangular file. And with help of your hand, you scratch. Move the glass tube and scratch. Okay. Again move, then scratch. Then after some time it will be scratched in a round form. Then it will slightly break. You see, it will be two pieces. Then there will be the edges. It will be very sharp. So you, it will. You see, you put to the flame. Then that sharp faces will be polished. That is known as flame polishing. Okay, that sharp place will be polished. Then it is used for making jet, making delivery tube like this. Okay, you see the surface now polished by flame. Okay, next is your cutting of glass rod. Okay, you see this is your glass rod. Glass rod is your solid and glass tube is your hole type. You see, this is your hole. There is hole, but there is no hole. Okay, this is your glass rod. Then similarly, you mark. Okay, similarly, you mark with your marker pen, because it will be easy if you mark with your marker pen. Then it will be easy. Then again, you take the triangular file. Okay, again you scratch. Okay, then slightly you see now surface is very plain or not, this surface. If there is any sharpness of the surface, then you take to the flame again. Okay, then there is known as flame polishing. Okay, you move your glass rod with your hand. Okay, then it will be polished. Okay, it is used for stirring the solution. What is the use of glass rod? Put the solution drop wise, stirring the solution. So these are the uses of glass rod. Okay, you see now edges are okay, no sharp. Okay, next, bending of tube. Next is your bending of tube. Again you see that previous one, this tube was previous one. Okay, I will bend this one with a flame. Okay, that is known as bending of a glass tube. You see, you take to the flame. Okay, at the middle. Okay, and you move that one, not in one place. Okay, and you press your finger toward inside, not outside, inside, means towards you, towards that hand, towards you. Then gradually, slowly, not suddenly, don't bend that tube. If you suddenly bend, then it will be break. You see, now tube bending. Okay,
So you see, this is your delivery tube. Air passing, okay. Then
drawing a jet. How to prepare a jet? Jet means, what do you mean by the jet?
Means nozzle, nozzle. Okay, jet. You see, again you take the plane. Okay, now what we'll do? You move with a pull, pulling the hand with opposite direction. You pull the hand with opposite direction. Okay, pull your hand. You see, after melting, it will be making the jet. You see, this is your jet. Okay, very sharp. Then what we'll do?
You just break the
nozzle. Okay, you just break the nozzle with that triangular file. Okay, you see, very minute hole is there, very minute hole. Okay, if you take by use of that is a spraying or wash the beaker or wash the bottle by using the nothing. Then boring a cork. How to boring a cork? You see, this one is your cork. Okay, this one is your cork. First you press, or you press by your leg. Okay, like this. Okay, you see, why you press this cork? Because it will be soft, because cork, actually cork is very hard. So by pressing with your leg, then it will be soft. Okay, then after that you take this one and with your cork borer, with your this, you see, this one is your cork borer. If you want to fit this tube, if you want to fit this tube in this cork borer, then you have to take the cork borer of dia less than the tube. You see, the dia of this cork borer is less than the tube, then it will be automatically tightly fitted. Okay children, so like this, you see, at the middle you put the cork borer and you move your hand like this. Okay, then it will be cut the cork at the center. Okay, then it will form. Okay, you see, at the middle. Okay, then it will form like this, this hole. Okay, this can be fitted in conical flask or test tube. Okay, and you can fit the jet here, you see. Okay, only gas can be coming from the conical flask. Okay, solution remain inside the conical flask. So this is the use of delivery tube and cork. Okay children, then this is the experiment number one. This is all our experiment number one. First cutting and cutting glass tube and glass rod, bending of glass tube, drawing a glass jet, boring a glass cork. Okay, this one is cutting a glass tube and rod, glass tube and both glass rod. Okay, bending a glass tube, drawing a glass jet, boring a cork, fitting the glass tube in four. Okay, time. Next.
9 minutes.
Next, melting point. We'll determine the melting point of given substance. Substance will be given to you. Substance will be given to you. This is your experiment number 2. Substance will be given to you. You have to calculate the melting point. You see the arrangement. You take the camera. You see the arrangement. You see, this is your thermometer. Okay. Temperature here. Then you see the arrangement. The capillary tube. Capillary tube having the solid. You see the solid. Okay, I have taken butanethal. Okay, that solid, any solid you have will give, means teacher will give you solid. You have to arrange like this. Okay, then this is the temperature.
then the tripod stand, beaker, okay, then tripod stand, wire gauge, then burner. Then you have to ignite the burner, okay, just you open the gas, okay, and this one. This is your melting point of solid, okay. You have to take two reading, okay. First reading, initial reading, when solid will start melting. Then at the last reading, when the all solid will melt, then that given the formula you see children, T1, temperature at which the unknown substance being to melt, starting of melt, melting point start, means melting of solid will start that temperature T1 degree Celsius. Temperature at which the substance completely melt, T2 degree Celsius. Then substance, melting point of substance, how to calculate the melting point of substance? T1 plus T2 divided by 2 degree Celsius, that is T degree C, means the temperature. Okay, so you see, now water, now warming, okay. Then after some time that water will boil. You don't touch the bulb of thermometer at the bottom of the beaker. Ball of the thermometer, you don't touch the beaker, because beaker temperature, bottom of the temperature will be maximum, high temperature. So it can be burst, okay. That bulb can be burst. So you don't, you just give some distance, bottom to that bulb of the thermometer. You see the temperature rising, now 35, okay. You see, going towards 40, okay. You see, now 40. You see, now there is a level at 45, going towards 50, like this, just you check, okay. Also you check the melting of that substance, okay, inside the beaker, this side, okay, not melt, it will gradually melt, okay. Okay, so then you see the temperature now more than 55, going towards 60, okay. Okay, children. So after some time, suppose that temperature solid will start melting. You see, I am writing here. Suppose solid start melting at 120 degree. Suppose solid start melting at 120 degree Celsius. That is your T1 degree Celsius. T1. Then solid will melt at suppose 126, okay. Degree Celsius. Then total, that is T1 degree Celsius plus T2 degree Celsius divided by 2, average, na? That is equal to, suppose 120 degree Celsius plus 126 degree Celsius divided by 2, that is equal to 240 46 degree Celsius divided by 2, that is equal to 123 degree Celsius. This is your melting point of solid. Okay. So, children, so you write both the experiment, experiment number 1, you write as a bitwise. Experiment number 1A, 1B, 1C, 1D, 1E. Okay, you write these are bitwise. This is all our experiment number 1. Experiment number 1A, 1B, 1C, 1D, and 1E. You write these are in experiment number 1. Okay, today's date. You did today's date. Then experiment number 2, you write this one. Okay, given solid observation. Then procedure already shared in group. Okay, so thank you till then. Okay, bye bye, take care. Okay.